Okay, so let's try to compute the sum of the elements in an array, right? Something very simple. Alright, so the first thing you should know if you are trying to optimize code or gauge the performance of different codes, you need to be familiar with some functions. OMP get W tick tells you the resolution of the timer in seconds, right? This means that the resolution of this timer is 1 nanosecond. Resolution is important, right? Because if you are timing a piece of code and let's say you're using a timer which is 1 second resolution and your code runs in 30 nanoseconds, right? Your timer is going to say 1 second. It took 1 second to execute that piece of code, or 0 seconds. Because you make a call to the timer, you execute the code, you make another call to the timer, right? And then you calculate the difference. That tells you how long it took to execute that piece of code. Ideally, the resolution of your timer should be considerably smaller than the time it takes to execute that code. Right, otherwise you're not going to get accurate results. So what OMP get W time returns me is the time in seconds starting from some universal time, right? Some number of years ago. Right, so you'll typically see very large values. Now what we're going to do is we're going to start with the sequential code and then slowly we're going to see how we can parallelize it. So here is what I have. I have a variable A which has 1 billion integers, right? And this is the array for which I want to calculate the sum. So how do I do that? First, I'm going to initialize the array. This is simple. I just create a loop and I'm going to initialize them with ones, okay? And then I simply add up the elements of the array. How do I do that? I keep a variable sum, initialize it to 0. And within this loop, I just say sum plus equal to ai, right? I mean, this is the simplest code that one can write. And I print the sum of the array elements. All right, and I also want to figure out how long it takes to execute this. For that, I'm going to use OMP get W time. So I make a call to OMP get W time before I do the summation and after I do the summation. I'm leaving the initialization out of this, right? I'm not timing the initialization. I'm just timing the time it takes to do the actual addition, the summing. The results are stored in T1 and T2, which are doubles. And finally, I say the sum of the array elements is whatever, %d. And this is the time it takes. And what is the time? It is T2 minus T1. Okay? That's the way you use timers. So I ran this code on some system and it took 13.85 seconds to run. Alright. So now let me try to parallelize this code. So this is how I parallelize it. I do the sum in parallel. For that, I introduce this hash pragma OMP parallel region. I keep intid as private and I say default everything else is shared. Right? So there's a default keyword which I can use to say what the default behavior is. So I can say default private, and then what will happen is that everything that I don't explicitly scope, that I don't explicitly say whether that's private or shared, will be treated as private, right? So in this case, I have just said default shared and intid are private. And then, I mean, I have my usual tid numt initializations, and then I execute this code for I equal to 0, I is less than error size I plus plus, sum plus equal to ai. I run this code and this is what I see. Well, I had a billion entries and this is 1.3 billion. So I expected the sum to be 1 billion, right? The sum should have been 1 billion, but I see some 1.3 billion of value, right? So what's wrong here? There's a race on sum. So there are two issues. Even if there was a race on sum, right, why am I seeing a value greater than 1 billion? Some increments would have gotten lost. So I should have seen a value less than 1 billion. There is some other fundamental problem with this code. So unless I specify otherwise, right, throughout I'm assuming that the number of threads is 4, that I've set the variable so that the number of threads is 4. So what are the 4 threads doing? What is thread 0 doing? It is going from I equal to 0 to I 1 billion and trying to add up the elements to sum. What is thread 1 doing? It's also going from 0 to billion minus 1, whatever. Right? So all the threads are actually trying to add up the entire array. If I wanted to actually do this, the value I should have seen is 4 billion. Right? Because there are 4 threads. But of course, there are 2 problems over here. One is that I have not actually parallelized the code. I'm asking each thread to do the exactly same thing. I'm asking each thread to compute the sum of the entire array from 0 to billion minus 1. Right? So that's one bug. And the other bug is that I have a race condition. Right? And we've already discussed this race condition enough times, that there is this variable sum. I'm trying to say sum plus equal to AI. Sum is a shared variable. Right? And all the threads are trying to update sum together. Doing an increment or addition, if I want to do sum plus equal to AI, even though in C it looks like a single instruction, it is broken down into a number of instructions. That data is fetched into the register, incremented, and then put back into the memory. Right? All of them are trying to change the value of sum together. So there's a race condition over here. Okay? And what is the time I see? 31 seconds, 31.1 seconds. What is the time I had seen earlier in the sequential code? 13 seconds. Why is this time gone up? I mean, I would have expected it to take 13.85 seconds, right? Because all the threads are doing the same work which that sequential thread was doing. Okay, so maybe there is a little bit of overhead in launching the threads, the forks and joins, but not this much. How can it go from 13 to 31? That is like sub-second kind of overhead. This is where cache coherency comes in. These 4 processors, they have their own cache. And these variables, particularly the variable sum, it's in the cache. Every time a thread updates sum, whatever the protocol be, whether it be the invalidate or the update protocol for cache coherency, it has overheads, right? So that cache coherency overhead is causing the increase in time. So look, we studied the bare minimum, okay, when we talked about cache coherency or architecture, we studied the bare minimum, which is essential for you to know in order to write parallel programs. You have to be aware of what cache coherency is. We did not get into the cache coherency protocols, but you have to be aware of the fact that cache coherency has its overheads. The moment you try to write parallel code, you're going to see some weird behavior which you are not expecting, and you have to try to explain that. Okay?